taxation specialization, international trade, foreign relations in trade, international fund management, banking administration, offshore management. So innumerable such resources have come and created innumerable disciplines in the study of business structure, like Harvard Institute of Business Studies, Massachusetts Institute of Business Studies, Phoenix Institute of Advanced Business Management, Minnesota University Department of Business Administration and High-End Business Studies, International Foreign Business Studies in the University of Pennsylvania. Innumerable universities, they have created doctorate, postdoctorate, specialization, special training, mutual training, intensive training, workshop and advanced learning in various systems of business due to advancement of this business scopes, spokes, ropes and throbs. All of the various dimensions of business, they have created more opportunities to dwell. But when sincerely speaking, when the opportunities and disciplines and dimensions of divisions of business are taken into account, the hopes of the society, proper hopes for each and everybody to withstand the society, whether proper training is being given, proper opportunities are being made, whether the made opportunities are standard or not, all of these things are put into very great turmoil, tension, threat and torture. So simultaneously governing all of these things, lot of things are there being given in your books. You can get lot of things through journals and various other workshops conducted by various eminent people, addressed by various stalwarts in business and wealth making technologies. But still I want to say something which is special, salient and separate from what you are reading in your book, and that frames the basic medulla oblongata of whatever you are going to read in your books and going to very pitiably and bitterly going to face in your environmental exposure in academic, professional and social extensions. Whenever we are exposed towards the society, it is not so joyous, so jubilant as we are enjoying something inside the books or seeing in PowerPoint presentations or reading within a group of like-minded people. We are going to face a society which is full of contradictions, adversities. So how to reap money and how to harvest money, how to place money, how to sleep with money on the pillow and the bed is very easy to read. But how to safeguard that money, how to be not a mute spectator when the same thing by means of opportunity or opportunistic wealth is grabbed from you from environmental resources, fraudulences and fallacies, how you are going to tackle the society, these things, this type of a fiscal courage, this type of a moral way of substantial fortification of not only your wealth but also your milk manufacturing unit. Even if your wealth can fade away, it can disappear from you, it can be debilitated and dismantled, but the hope of wealth manufacturing unit or the fiscal machinery inside you befitted, making you to be a perennial hope finder and scope finder for establishing yourself in the universe, that should not be faded, that should not vanish at all. And that needs a special type of training and teaching, which unfortunately is not available in most of the textbooks, that is learned by people when they are exposed to time at their age of 50s and 60s, at the time of which it will be too late for them to relearn everything or to de-learn what they have already learnt. It is such a very crucial occasion wherein by that is just like a person who is blinded to get into Surya Namaskara or sun worship at the time where it could not be revocable at all. So I want to just put in the limited time frame for the things specially that are there available with us. You know that business technology that has innumerable divisions and modern universities and various other research institutes, I've already told, they are in pursuit of lot of expansions. And coming to intelligence, what is intelligence? What is mere business management? Business management, we cannot say that it is devoid of intelligence, and we cannot say that business intelligence is totally devoid of. Somebody asked the question, if there is business management, then what is BI, business intelligence? And do you want to say that there is business intelligence and business idiocy? There is no such classification like that. Everything is framed of intelligence. But you see, whenever a person is managing, the management is more concerned with the trend, the product, the interpersonal and cross-personal relations that are there within the organizational team. That is more with understanding the potential of the person and making a proper supervision of their sincere execution of their capabilities and dexterities. It is more personal than technical. So the business intelligence deals with management, but more with technical intelligence. Business management, no doubt, that has technical facilities, but more with personal relations and organizational teaming and grouping. Now, science has expanded, and the cyberspace, they have expanded the cyberspace by which the data mining, processing, everything is conducted in cyberspace. So unless, apart from mere managerial relation of subordinate relationship, superordinate relationship, coordinate relationship, knowledge transfer, mutual information sharing, hierarchy and delegation of proper work and sharing, all of these things are managerial. Now, due to the advent of modern technology, especially the knowledge process outsourcing, KPO units, more than that of the traditional conventional units, they have understood that mere managerial skills or business management is totally impotent to govern the present syllabus. So due to which they have invented a new syllabus of intelligence which has, apart from personal relations, understanding of techno-personal, personal-cum-technal, techno-techno and interpersonal relations are the four pillars of the modern intelligence. Between person and person, between person and technology, impact of technology and person and vice versa, technology to technology transfer. This has created business intelligence. So it starts with reporting. Business intelligence starts with reporting. What you have understood, what you have identified, what you are processing, you have to make a clarity on it. The clarity should be in drafting or a conceptive alignment inside your mind which you have to present, which is known as drafting. So business intelligence is explained by the modern scientists or business technocrats as a science that deals with, number one, skills of the person, number two, application of the same skills, technology that is available, and practice of the technology. So the skills, processing of the skills, technology, their adaptation, application, as well as the practices, these five components, they form business intelligence. What is your resources? How you are going to bring it in practice? What is technology? What is application? How to mingle both of them in a collateral way as a rail platform or as a railway parallelism to make a collaborative and collateral movement of both the things to form the business success is known as business intelligence now. Business intelligence means you should have five major types of knowledge. Number one is you should understand what is the source. It is known as historical study of business. Second thing is precedental study. You have to study about two things. One is considering similar institutions on similar grounds based on success studies, similar institutions on failure studies. Likewise, sophisticated institutions, simple institutions, growth level, abundance level, achievement level, target level, various levels of various types of business on various exposures of environment, they should be clearly done. Now there are innumerable softwares available for that. You need not go for a data collection, processing, mining, mutuality, sharing, tabulation, categorization. These things are totally unnecessary. We are having softwares like BizFun, etc. They have made a textual software of all of these precedental studies, which we can tailor it as per the conceptive environment or the business environment which we are experiencing in our business scale, that we can utilize that. So it is understanding of historical events, it is understanding of procedural events, it is understanding for current affairs, what is the political influence, economical influence, social influence, industrial relations, product demand and scarcity, cultivation, export and import policy variations, all these things are coming under current studies. But from that, competitive studies, who is against you, who is with you, who is away from you, who is along with you, behind you, beyond you, around you, all of these various people are different level of urges of your competition. You have to read about the competitive studies also. Then there is a good science in business. It is not like astrological prediction, but there is a prediction. How the prediction is made? When you understand precedences, when you apply the same thing to the current affairs, you can create prediction table with approximacy of 60% to 90% with accuracy rate of 10%. That is accuracy rate. 60 to 90% we can arrive at approximacy. This is known as prediction science. So business intelligence, business management that gives you like weather forecasting. It may rain or not. Have you heard weather forecasting? It may rain or not. It may be today or tomorrow. It may be rain or mere snow, or it may fall on you or your neighbor. These things are weather forecasting. So it has more probability. That should be, see, they are not God or they are not nature. They cannot say anything clearly. But probability should be more than 60%. If it is may or may not more, we cannot come anything like that. So mere business management has more probability than assurance. Business intelligence augments the probability rate from 60% to 90% of approximately. When you understand technology, when you understand the prediction science as per the theories that we are learning from the other competitive exposures, collaborative exposures, different things, distance things, limited things, various exposures with companies by use of software, you can take also your project and on your own area and your own arena and province, you can make a report and understand how predictive thing is there. So now all of the management institutes, they have to contemplate. Now you know that DME, that is Diploma in Mechanical Engineering, before the advent of engineering colleges in 1550s and 60s, noble doctors are there. First, doctors are very great in profession and everybody preferred academic, professional, matrimonial preferences are made for doctors. then for DMB engineers, then for BE people, then BE people, they have become now MS. Now MS has not been properly satiated. Even MS people, they are just, MS is just like the initials.